use log properties to combine the expressions into a single log. Number one, we have log base 5 of 3 plus log base 5 of 4. Because we have a sum of two logs, we should be thinking about the product property of logarithms, which is this property here, log base a of m plus log base a of n equals log base a of the product of m and n. But there's a few things we should notice about this property. To begin, both logs have to have the same base, and then secondly, the coefficients of the logs must be 1. Notice for number 1, we do have two logs with the same base, base 5, and the coefficients are 1, and therefore we can combine the two logarithms into a single log by applying the product property of logarithms. Log base 5 of 3 plus log base 5 of 4 equals log base 5 of the product of 3 and 4. And since 3 times 4 is 12, we have log base 5 of 12. Number 2, we have log base 3 of 12 minus log base 3 of x. Notice here, because we have a difference, we should be thinking about the quotient property of logarithms, which is log base a of m minus log base a of n equals log base a of the quotient of m and n. And again, notice how both logarithms must have the same base. This indicates we can combine the difference as log base 3 of 12 divided by x. Number 3, we have log base 4 of the quantity x squared plus 4 minus log base 4 of the quantity x squared plus 8. This is very similar to number 2. Notice both logs are base 4 and we have a difference. We can combine the two logs as log base 4 of the quotient of x squared plus 4 and x squared plus 8. Now, sometimes we can simplify these quotients and sometimes we can't. X squared plus 4 does not factor. The only common factor is 1. The same is true for x squared plus 8. And therefore, this quotient does not simplify. Remember, we cannot simplify across addition, meaning we cannot simplify x squared over x squared or 4 over 8. And now let's look at number 4, which is a little bit different. We have log base 7 of 2x minus 2 log base 7 of the quantity x plus 2. We cannot apply the quotient property of logs because of the 2 in front of log base 7 of the quantity x plus 2. We first need to apply the power property of logarithms, which recall is p times log base a of m is equal to log base a of m to the power of p. So let's first write the difference as log base 7 of 2x minus, we can move the 2 to the exponent position on the quantity x plus 2, which gives us minus log base 7 of the quantity x plus 2 squared. And now in this form, we can apply the quotient property of logarithms. Log base 7 of 2x minus log base 7 of the square of x plus 2 is equal to log base 7 of the quotient of 2x and the square of x plus 2. And again, the quotient does not simplify. I hope you found this helpful.